Being a farmer every day, you feel a sense of pride. You feel passionate in what you're doing. You have an accomplishment at the end of the year. We're just one individual operation here in Central Indiana, but what we do every day is we feed the world. Hi, I'm Andrew Fansler. I'm the CEO of Fansler Farms. I'm a first generation farmer from Shelbyville, Indiana. When I was 3 years old, on my third birthday, I got a John Deere pedal tractor. And at that point, I knew that that was what I was gonna do the rest of my life, is be a farmer.
When I came on board at Fansler Farms, we were probably farming around 1,100 acres, had two small tractors here. You know, 8 years later, we're pushing the 5,000 acre mark. So that's a pretty good accomplishment to be proud of.
We are on a 50-50 crop rotation with corn and soybeans, both white corn, yellow corn, seed soybeans, and tofu, non-GMO soybeans.
Andrew's passion for farming started before I knew him. He bought his first farm as a teenager. When I met him and started dating him, that's all he talked about. All of our dates revolved around either being in a tractor or a combine, and to this day, that's still how he is.
He puts everything other than his family into farming, and he does that because of his family.
Being a first generation farmer, I've had to earn everything that I have. Not being from a family farm, not having all that backing, I knew that I was gonna have to set myself apart as opposed to just doing what everybody else is doing. As hard as I've worked to build this, I want it to be continued on. We're growing crops, we're growing a business, we're growing a culture, but what are we doing it for? We're doing it for the future. We're doing it for the next generation. We're doing it to be sustainable down the road. Some things that we do for sustainability is, one, we try to use no-till as much as possible. We have tried for many years now with cover cropping. Another thing that we're really big on is field tile. And we're finding even in the drought years, the systematically tiled farms are out yielding the farms with not any tile in them.
We're losing, you know, more acres every day. You know, we're gonna have to try to be more innovative with science and technology to try to boost more yields and try to raise, you know, more than we ever have with less than what we have.
What sets us apart from many other growers is our willingness to bring in other ideas and adapt them into the ag industry. You know, we started down the road of variable rate seeding, variable rating our fertilizer, and variable rating our nitrogen. These are things that made us more efficient, made us financially better, and gave us a better understanding what it is that we're using, why we're using it, and when is the right time to use it.
Andrew was one of the first farmers in the area to even attempt to use the new technology we have today, you know, auto steer, auto guidance, all that stuff. There's very few people using it, and you know, he was on the ground floor level of that. And you know, we're a step ahead a lot of people because they're just now getting into it because they're forced to. We've been using it for a long time.
I think it's important for young people to understand what farming will be in the future, and it's not just about working 18 hours a day and being dirty and stinky and being in the bad conditions. It's also going to take some very technology savvy people. It's going to take people that are understanding of the autonomous equipment, of finance, of marketing, of networking, to help really build a farm operation. Although I may have to have a computer with me and I may adapt to changes in technology, my office is still out in a field and out working with nature and being a part of the environment. I'm so passionate about farming and being involved in the future of farming that I'm certain until my last days here on Earth that I will be involved in agriculture.
Bayer. Science for a better life.